It's starting to feel like summer madness again.
Off of first watch. All right, let me dive into it. MVP, you are clearly not ready for the big stage. In a big room where there's thousands of people standing for hours and hours and hours, they need to be entertained. MVP just wasn't it. He wasn't entertaining enough. I don't know if he thought that the punchlines would work, but it didn't. MVP proved that he's zero entertainment in the big stage. Maybe over time he could learn to get there, maybe from guidance from vets, but his bars fell short. A lot of air balls. It's never good to react to your own bars. It's never good to react to your own bars if it's your first time on stage. It's just not hitting. Real name Brandon was poised. Never looked like the moment was too big for him. Didn't really seem overly excited. Just stuck to who he is and stuck to the game plan. Slow feed the people all the way to 25K. Easy. Lou Castro. Lou Castro is here. A great, great style. I mean, he is great for the big room. He actually belongs on a big stage, in my opinion. I would like to see him get a little bit intricate in his bars, but he'll get there. If he brings his rhymes up to his performance, he will be nearly impossible to stop. He'll be one of them ones in the foreseeable future. Now let's get to Easy the Block Captain. Easy the Block Captain has taken over as the leader of his class. Sorry, Real Sick.
Put our heads down.
Real Sick had a good battle with Av. Majority of the people say he lost that one. The URL app says he lost that one. Easy had control the entire time. I mean, it looked like he was the vet up there. He had control over the crowd. He had control over his voice. Nothing else I could say about him. He was just fantastic. All the way around, well-rounded. He sticks to his lane and he does it really, really well. He has lines that are hard to forget. Everything sticks with you. The last few battles he had, he went toe-to-toe with seasoned vets. He's not going against just any rinky-dink Joe Schmo from the record shop. We are all waiting to see Easy to Block Captain versus Goods. We can't wait for that one. We want to see if he can talk that talk against someone who talks grown man. I'm interested to see if Easy the Block Captain can use that same style against Goods. It'll be an interesting matchup. As for Chess, congratulations, you're back. Now, I'm actually pretty shocked at the result of the Hollow vs. Shine. I thought that Shine was going to come back after losing from Chilla, having a debatable classic 2-on-2 versus Av and Fonz. I expected Shine to just leave Earth, but he was having trouble landing some of his lines in the crowd, so maybe it's a crowd thing. Hollow had good angles, so at the end of the battle, you more than likely had Hollow winning the battle. His angles just stuck more. Sad outcome from this battle is that we might not get that Daylight versus Shine. Now, I'm completely surprised on this one. I was wrong on this one. I had John Adon winning this all the way. There was no way I thought Surf was going to win this at all. But somehow Surf tapped into his pre-caffeine bag and was able to get John out of here. Only we're not only out of the woods yet, we have to see a consistent Surf, but this is a start. This is a Surf that we've all been waiting for. This is the type of Surf that a lot of people love to cheer for. So if he can consistently give us this Surf, then he could regain his spot as one of the best battle rappers out in this era. This is actually one of the best Surfs I've ever seen. I mean, hands down. I can't really think of a better Surf that was better than this one. I don't think I've seen him come out with all three rounds like this and not letting up from beginning to end. I mean, it's crazy. I mean, the Geechee Gotti battle was good. That was a good classic Surf, but this one was on a whole nother level. Hands down, will we get this type of Surf again? If so, stick to the big room because it seems like this is where he's clicking on all cylinders. So my thoughts on Mook and Reed. I think that this battle should have been in a small room. I would have liked to see this in a caffeine room where Mook was on one side, Reed was on the other side. Mook has him and his Harlem folks. Reed has him and his Philly folks. And they just battle old school. It was supposed to be that way back in the day. I mean, we wanted to hear Reed's flows. I mean, that's what he's known for. We wanted to hear Reed get into different pockets with his rhyme patterns. For something like Mook and Reed, we needed that nostalgic feeling of that Smack DVD and Too Raw for the Streets. This is the type of setting we all wanted and needed. We just didn't need those performances displayed on SM11 at all. They were just sitting up there talking to each other. Story time with Mook and Reed. That's what it was. Geechee versus Cow. I don't really have much to say anything about this one. I mean, Geechee had good rounds. Cow had good rounds. Geechee not really clean in the third. So I could see how people can give Cow the battle 2-1. But this battle was cool. This didn't really do anything for their careers. We just wanted that street talk lingo, basically. The battle was cool. It didn't move any of their careers forward or backwards. In the future, I'll do more breakdowns of the narratives of SM11. This is Battle Rap Critic. Don't forget to comment, subscribe, and hit the like button.